Hi, and welcome to Matchmove for Production by VFX Tutors. I'm Josh, and in this video, we'll be continuing with the shot MM012. In part two, we'll be importing our camera to Maya and getting it ready to be used. So Maya has opened up. The first thing that we want to do is import our camera. So if we go File, Import, and we'll go to where we exported our camera out. We want to import our mail script. So it's coming in green, so what we can do, we can just go to our shading and use default material. It's coming with a no shader attached to it from 3DEqualizer. So what we can do, we can hide our point group. And we can look for our camera. So the first thing we'll do, we want to switch out our image sequence because we've got the full 4K in it. It could be quite heavy to use. So if we select our camera with this little camera icon, go to our attribute editor and go to our image plane, which is just here on the right. Then image name, and click on the file. Now we want to go to our file where we exported out our undistorted plate. Select it and open. Now select use image sequence. Change your alpha gain to 0.7. And change your depth to 1. So now if we select shading wire unshaded, you can see that our geo's here. What we can do, we can go face and we can delete this extra geo because we know that's not correct. We get to perspective, panels perspective here, and we can just look around and we can see that these are like these bits where it's tried to bridge across, which is not quite very good. Select that and go to panels perspective, and it's sort of made that beach there, so we can delete that. Perspective again. It's done the same here, so we just delete that. Go to panels. So now we can. Might have to do that. That's fine. Now we can see our camera's working well. So now if we go to our panel's perspective and just look at our whole scene, we turn on our grid, we can see that everything's really quite a bit too small. So if we go to our perspective with and if we hold backslash, so if we go back, we hold backslash, or if you press backslash, you can see at the bottom it's changing our 2D pan zoom. So whilst we're in 2D pan zoom, we can zoom in. So if we hold backslash and right click and middle mouse click to move around, we can sort of see there's a road there, a beach. So we're gonna have to sort of guesstimate the size of this scene. So what we'll do, we'll go with classic 6 foot man again. So if we make a cylinder, what's that? 184, 20 wide. So if we press backslash to go out, we can see that this is absolutely huge. So if we go perspective and see how big our guy is, so imagine that's a 6 foot guy. We'll just bring it up. What we'll do is we'll select our scene. We'll make sure that you select the scene, not anything under the scene, because we can scale anything we want and it won't break anything. You see the camera is scaling up with it. So we'll keep scaling it up. And I'm going to use this little area here as a point of reference. So I can actually, if I press insert and hold V, I can change the pivot point of the group. So now I've changed it to there. If I press insert again, so I turn that off, hold V, I can now snap that to the cylinder. Press F to zoom in on it. So we'll just put this cylinder back here at the origin. Now if we go back to our perspective, not camera, and hold backslash to 2D pan zoom in. It's quite sensitive and you might lose it. So if you select your camera and you can scroll down, go to display options, 2D pan enabled, and what you can do, you can put this back to 1. Was it 0? Yeah, 0. And sorry, 1. And that will reset it. So it can be quite sensitive sometimes when you're panning around. So what we can do now, we've got that there, we can keep scaling it up. Although our cylinder is shrinking, it's not. It's our scales getting bigger. So we're going to keep scaling our scene. So the cylinder looks like a reasonable size guy on that beach. And this is just a guesstimation. We'll just go to our translate, just a big scale. Select a scale, we'll go like 800. Still needs to be bigger. Let's drop 1200. It's going to be like this. If we press backslash and zoom in, it's very sensitive sometimes. So we'll go back to that and reset that. We just go to our perspective actually. Let's have a look. So our clipping plane is, so if we select our camera and our view, perspective, perspective shape, go up. And we want to change our perspective camera, so this will select whatever we're looking through. If we change our far clipping plane, add a couple zeros, we'll be able to see. So it looks like we're a little bit too big now. Perspective camera. Make it a little bit bigger, sorry. You can see it's... You can see it's tiny there, maybe a little bit smaller. So we'll go with that. That's pretty small. It's about reasonable. And you can always change it if it's a bit too big. So we'll delete that. So what we can do, we can select our point mesh, group it. As we did before, we need to make sure we shift here out of the group, because then that will allow it to take on the transforms. So what we'll do, we'll freeze that. Modify reset transformations. So back at the origin. We'll do the same for the locator group. We'll just freeze those transformations. But we can't do it for the camera. If we do that, it will take on the translations and scale and break the camera. So say, like, if we look here, it's all working fine. Then if we shift P that out, it's all broken. So we need to make sure that we get our animation off this camera. And we'll put it onto a locator. So if we go create up at the top, locator, select our camera, then select the locator with control, left click, go up to your modeling, your menu, and go to rigging, and go to constrain, point, and constrain orient. So now if you select the locator and press F, you can scale it up. And now you can see that it follows our camera. So now if we select our camera and select the translations and rotations, go edit, keys, and bake simulation. That's now baked the animation onto that locator. And we can get rid of the constraints. So now when we shift P this out of the group, obviously when you move it, it disappears. So now we need to select our locator, then our camera, then go to constrain again and point, constrain orient. Now our camera is following the locator. So now we need to select our translations and rotations in our channel box, select edit, keys, and bake simulation. Now we can remove the constraints from that. We can delete that locator. We can delete that old scene, and we can group this and call this scene. Call it scene or match move, it's up to you. It's whatever makes you remember what is into this group. Cool, so if we get perspective and camera. Camera, where's the gun? Cool. Then we need to change our file clipping plane for our camera. So select our camera, the wind file camera, add a couple zeros to it, to the file clipping plane, and now you can see your set geo. And now it should all work pretty good. And you get some artifacts here, but if we select our camera, let's change that to 1. Should fix it. Cool, so we're now done for this shot. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and hit that like button and subscribe for more like this.